Everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do check in with a quick Friday Reads. So for the last little while, I haven't really posted anything about what I'm reading because I'm trying to group things together for potential reviews. And I'm in the middle of some books that kind of go along with other books that I've read in February and March. And I'm just waiting to finish them off so I can group them together. So one of the books I'm reading right now is Hans Christian Andersen's biography. It's not very short and it incorporates a lot of information and I want to go through it steadily. I'm also almost done the Norwegian Fairy Tales book. This will get its own video because there's a lot to talk about. I'm really loving it though. Norwegian fairy tales are different from the Icelandic folk tales and fairy tales I read earlier in the year, but they have a lot of things in common. What's interesting about these ones are kind of like their structure, so there will be more to talk about here. The main novel that I'm in the middle of right now is Growth of the Soil by Knut Hamsun. He is a Norwegian author. He won the Nobel Prize in Literature. Honestly, one of the best books I've read in a while. I'm going through it slowly, and there's no audiobook of this to kind of keep me going along, so I'm doing it kind of pure reading, you know? And it's really nice in this time of isolation, so this will be a review in part with another book that I read by Hamsun in February, so I'm waiting to finish that off. Now, another book that I read, but I don't think I want to review in full at any point, is Bear by Marian Engel. This is said to have been the winner of the Governor General's Award, which is a Canadian award. Now, I'm gonna put the cover up here so you can understand why this book caught my attention. I thought, okay, this could be interesting. I mean, what does she do for a living to afford those? And turns out she's an archivist. She's kind of given this project off-grid to go to this island or peninsula in Ontario where this really rich man has a mansion and he has a lot of archives for her to go through. Now, what happens next is a little bit complicated. She f***ed the bear. I guess it wasn't that complicated. It turns out to be a very odd novel and I'm very confused about it all. And it wasn't really well written, in my opinion. Like, if this was written in an appealing way, in a way that was like drawing on nature and had more beautiful and intricate language, I think I would have been behind it a little bit more. Given the way it was written and the content and the merging of the two, it was just kind of fallen flat for me personally. Then I've been reading some short stories that are kind of dark and gothic and supernatural-ish by Arthur Machen. I'll definitely have reviews coming up of all of these. I just have to finish them. I am also reading short stories by Hans Christian Andersen himself, and it's the annotated edition, and I'm trying to kind of keep in touch with all of it. This is something that I've started a while ago. Like, all of these books have not been started, you know, today or even this week. These are books that I've kind of been going in parallel with since maybe the beginning of February. Right now, I'm just waiting to finish all of them and have something of value to say. But I have been reading and this is what's been going on. So I just thought I'd check in with you and tell you what I'm reading. I look forward to hearing from you because I hope you'll tell me what you are reading right now and how many books you're reading at the moment. I hope all is well with you and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!